remains the same. Yeah. Your history can prove there's nothing you can't do. You're faithful.
Like a lonely.
Always something trying to steal my mood. My crazy thoughts trying to kill my groove. That's when I hear a voice whisper through the noise that brings a bigger picture into view. Whenever the clouds.
Hello, everyone, and welcome again to today's worship service. As you can see, today we are worshiping on the campus of Northridge High School, home of the Jaguars. So, shout out to Northridge. We are excited to be here. We're excited because we get to share the word of the Lord with you today. Today, we want to talk from the subject, get happy. We have so much going on in this world today that wants us to be sad, wants us to be discouraged, wants us to be frustrated, wants us to have anxiety and even worries. Yeah. But you know what? That comes from just the human experience. Yeah. It's natural to be upset, it's natural to worry, but because we are not of this world, we are of the kingdom of God, we are Christians and we believe in the power of God, we are able to be happy.
Yeah.
And happiness comes from the things of God. If we're going to live in this world and if we're going to be the light that God wants us to be, you're not going to be that way if we're angry. We can only be that way if we get happy.
Yes. And in the word, we're going to look at Jeremiah 17, chapter 7, verse. It says, blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord and whose hope is in the Lord. So we are blessed when we find our trust, when we find our hope in God. And when our trust is hope and hope is in God, we're happy.
It's easy
because
to get happy.
It's easy to get happy because we're not thinking about this world. Because if we put our trust and hope in the world, guess what? Things fail. Look at right
all
now.
The time.
When we sat, we have already mapped out what we thought this year was going to be. But look, if we put our trust and our hope in our plans, in our prom, in our graduation, in our recitals, in our dance team,
in
our GPA, guess what? Those things are subject to fail.
Amen.
But one thing that will not fail is trusting and believing in God.
Amen.
So let's get glad that we serve a God that is allowing us right now to be happy, whether it's raining, whether it's cloudy, whether it's cold, whether the sun is shining or not. He calls us to be happy because he continues to protect us. He continues to bless us. And most of all, God's presence stays and resides within us.
So truthfully, ask yourself, do you find happiness in the things of God? Or do you find happiness in the things of this world? In the kingdom of God, there is happiness. And if you haven't experienced true happiness, that's because you have not experienced the true love of Jesus Christ. So today, we want you to know that Jesus is available to you. And the happiness that you seek, even in a pandemic, even in a world that is going haywire, that happiness is found in Jesus.
Yeah.
I'm holding here my about to be 2-year-old daughter, and our 8-month-old son.
Yeah.
And in school, they have this chart.
Say happy.
Happy.
Good. Glad.
Glad.
Silly.
Sad.
Sad.
So in school, they have this chart, just like Minister Courtney just went over with her, that denotes their facial expression when they are happy, when they are sad, and when they are glad.
Happy.
Happy.
Sad.
Sad.
Angry.
Ugly.
Scared.
Scared.
Silly.
Silly.
Excited. Surprised.
Shy.
Embarrassed. Good job. High five. Great job. High five, Academy.
As you stated earlier, when they're happy, they have a certain look on their face. And God is looking for a people who will be happy, who will get happy, not contingent upon the circumstances that they're going through, but contingent upon His word. And His word, we can be happy. Today, we want to leave you with this, is that no matter what you're going through, no matter what you're involved in, no matter what your school is like, no matter what your family is like, no matter what is going on, you can get happy. Today we encourage you, like we always do, to in everything you do, let's exalt Christ's everlasting love and make God proud.
Yeah.